Our God is healer, awesome in power, our God. Our God, he's great. Amen. He's great. Everybody turn with me in Isaiah chapter 65, verse 9. God says that I will bring forth a seed out of Jacob and out of Judah, an inheritor of my mountains, and mine elect shall inherit it, and my servants shall dwell there. Amen. This is the word that God gave us as Youth Aflame 2018, but I just wanted to mark it, and this scripture will propel us throughout the year. Amen. Two things God is doing this year. Two things. Election. He has elected us. He says he has elected us. Amen. He has elected us. If you are that who is called by the name of God, I want you to know that you are elected. Amen. Number two thing that God is doing, he says, and my servants shall dwell there. And this year, I want you to know that anything that you put your hands to do, any goal that you write, you shall dwell in it. Now, to dwell, it means to stay. Amen. It means to stay in his inheritance. When God says, can you imagine God says, I have mountains. I have mountains. And the Bible says that God is seated in heaven and the earth is the what? The footstool. The earth is where God places the feet. And he says, now you can imagine God calling a mountain. How does the mountain of God look like? How does it look like? Can you picture this supernatural being, this image, someone seated in heaven, seated so high, and the feet are touching the earth? The feet are touching the earth. It's like we cannot fathom with our mindset. We cannot really picture. And this, he says that I have my mountains. Now, if the whole earth, which have mountains in it, he places his feet upon the earth. And now he says that I have mountains. So how does the mountains of God, or how do the mountains of God look like? They must be huge. No, they must be huge. And one thing that gives us is God does not give petty visions. God does not give small visions. He does not give small things. He gives great things because he is great. And what he says is, I have elected you. I have elected you. Now, election, when we talk about election, it means that there are other people. It means that it was only you, but there were other people. But he says, I have elected you. When we did the elections, there were many, many, many aspirants, candidates that were on the ballot. Names were there. But when we went to do the election, we could select the best candidate, right? We could select the best candidate. And the candidate who got most votes, those are the people who we said they won, right? According to our constitution, according to the way we do things, those are the people we consider victors, right? So God says that I have elected you, meaning that I have called you out. Amen. I have called you out. I have picked you. I have picked you out of a people. I have selected you out of a people. Praise God. And this year, what God is saying is that he has picked us out of people that we may become inheritors of his mountains. Praise God. Inheritors of his mountains. And all I want you to understand this year, an inheritor, when we talk about inheritance, when we talk about I have inherited something, it means this thing wasn't probably mine from the beginning, right? It belonged to someone, probably from a family or not even from a family, but it's someone's property. And now you come to inherit that property. You come to inherit it. It doesn't matter whether you are the son or you are just an innocent inheritor, or the thing is, when you inherit, you claim the possession. Amen. You possess, you become the owner. You become the owner. And so what God is saying is this here, he's making us owners of his mountains. Amen. He's making us owners of his mountains. And one thing I want us to move with this year is this word. Everywhere we step, everything we do, we proclaim and say, I'm the owner of God's mountains. In your school, those are going to schools, go to that school and proclaim, I'm the owner of God's mountains. In this school, I represent God. I'm the owner of this mountain. Praise God. Praise Jesus. I want us also to read a scripture in the book of Romans. Do I have people who have been elected in the house? Do I have people who have been elected in the house? We have been elected to do great things. We've been elected. I want you to proclaim. Every time we proclaim, I've been elected to do this thing. I've been elected to do business. I've been elected to become great in my school. I've been elected that I may live in the righteousness of God. I've been elected so that I can get the favor of God. Amen. Even when things seem not to be working. Even when things seem not to be working, even when you're in your hardest moment, the times when you're not seeing the light out of it, they usually say between a rock and a hard place. I don't know this hard place, what it is. Is it? Is it a stone or iron? But what I want us to say, even if you're there, is proclaim that I am elected. I am elected. I am elected. Because the word of God, when you proclaim the word of God, because it is the word of God, it will work. Amen? It will work. And the Bible says, before we go to Romans, let's go to Deuteronomy chapter 30, verse 14. It's the same with Romans. It's just the same scripture. But I want us to read it from the original text, that is Deuteronomy. You're there? Deuteronomy chapter 30, verse 14. Chapter 30, verse 14. If you're there, say amen. Hallelujah. But the word is very nigh unto thee, in thy mouth and in thine heart, that thou mayest do it. Again, the word is very nigh unto thee, in thy mouth and in thine heart, that thou mayest do it. And the same has been repeated in Romans now chapter 10 verse 8. Yeah, it says, but what saith it? The word is nigh unto thee, even in thy mouth and in thine heart. That is the word of faith which we preach. The word is near to you. That's what the Bible says. The word is near to you. It is near to your mouth and it is near to your heart. So the word is near to your mouth and the word is near to your heart. Now we are the elected. You are that person who have been elected by God. And one tool that God has given, one mountain that I know God has given unto us is his word. Amen. One thing that God has made us to inherit is his word. Because his word is like the, it's like the password. His word is like the everything. So God has caused us to inherit his word. The reason why sometimes we are pressed and we remain in the same place for so long is because we have not realized what we have inherited. We've not realized what we've inherited. One thing we've inherited is the word. And he says, the word is near to you. The word is so near to you. And it's not this near, but the word is near to your mouth. So near to you in the mouth and in the heart. And the Bible says that out of the abundance of the heart, the mouth speaketh. So if you have inherited the word is in your heart. When it is in abundance, then you can speak it. Amen? You can speak it. And so, when God says, I have made you to inherit my mountains, what he wants us to do, he wants us to speak what he has given us to inherit. He wants us to use the key that he has given us. And that is the word. Amen? That is the word. In every circumstance, in everything we face in life, when we are in this globe, what we can use and succeed and prosper is the word. Amen? It is the word. And that is the first inheritor, the word. Praise God. Come with me, the same Romans chapter 11. Let's come with me. Chapter 11, verse 16. It says, for if the first fruit be holy, the lump is also holy. And if the root be holy, so are the branches holy. I read again, for if the first fruit be holy, the lump is holy. And if the root be holy, so are the branches holy. In simple words, what the scripture says, if the root of a plant, let's use a plant. If the root of a plant is holy, then it talks of the first fruit. The fruits that this tree will bear will also be holy. And we've read a scripture in Isaiah 65 that says that out of Jacob, God has chosen, he has elected us, and he has selected out of the seed of who? Of Jacob. It means we can't have the root until we have the seed. No. We can't have the root until we have the seed. And now it says, out of Jacob, I have selected a seed for me. And he says, because there is this seed. Now he says, if the root is holy, then the fruit will also be holy. What this means is, the seed cannot produce fruit which is holy unless it becomes a root. So, no, it cannot produce fruit until it becomes the root. And the seed cannot become the root until it dies. Right? It cannot be the root, it cannot be the plant, it cannot be the tree until it dies. So out of the seed of Jacob, I have selected you. And I have selected you that you may be the first fruit. Yeah? You may bear the fruits. But now before that fruit, there is the process of the seed and the seed dying and the seed now becoming the root. And then the root goes deep. It becomes again the shoot. And then when it becomes the shoot, it bears the fruit. Amen. Amen. And one thing that I know God is calling us, God is calling each and every one of us, because everyone is a seed. You remember when we were saying, I'm a seed. Just say it one more time. I am a seed. I am a seed. I am a seed. Now, a seed cannot be alone. Yeah? A seed has to go down. A seed has to go down. There is the depth in the seed. Amen? There's the depth in the seed. Now, this chosen seed, which is you and I, a chosen seed, what we're going to do, we need to go to a place where we know that we are elected. Amen? We need to understand that first, that I am elected. 2018, I am elected. That should be in my mind. I am elected. I'm not just Pastor Josh. I'm not just any other person. You are not just Major. You are not just Bomb. You are not just Stacy. We are not just that. We have been elected. Amen? We have been elected. An elected person is different from someone who just kept themselves there. They're so different. This is someone who have been elected. And so we've been elected. We did not just appear. We were elected. Amen. You did not just come to church because it's a Sunday. You were elected for you to be here today. Amen. Because God knew there is something for you today. Amen. And now this seed, it's elected. But this seed has to do some death. It has to die. This seed has to go to the soil. This seed has to go to a place whereby the outer coat of the seed is removed. Praise God. That outer coat of the seed, it has to be removed. And probably that's where some of us are. Some of us, probably that's where you are. God is taking away that outer covering. Praise God. God is taking that outer covering. And when God is taking that outer covering, you sometimes we tend to complain. Sometimes we tend to say that, God, oh God, why are you allowing me to go through this? Why are you allowing me to face this? But what God is doing, God is just taking the outer, because he has elected you. Amen. He has elected you. And then there's that other process. Now when he has taken the outer coat, there is the process of dying. There's the process of dying. The seed has to die. And for the seed, when the seed dies, it doesn't remain stiff. No, it doesn't remain stiff. It doesn't. When the seed dies, it stinks. When you take a seed, I don't know if you did this. When I was in primary, we were doing some tule tumikebe. Those cans, then you are told to put the maize. And one thing that I realized with my can, after around 4 to 5 days, I was watering it, and when the seed was dying, it was stinking. It was stinking. There's the stinking part when the seed is dying. And probably sometimes that's where we are. That's where we are. And people smell at you and they say, you're stinking. Yeah, they feel there's that stench that is coming forth. It's coming forth. But it's not because you don't have value. It's because you are in the process of becoming a root. Amen. You are in the process of becoming a root. Turn to your neighbor and tell them, I may be stinking today. I may be stinking today, but I am in the process. I am in the process. Praise God. Never look at someone and despise them. And I want us, as the youth ministry, I want us never to look at anyone and despise them. It doesn't matter how they look. It doesn't matter if they have spent a week without taking a shower. It doesn't matter. It doesn't matter. They may be. I'm not saying people shouldn't shower. I'm not saying people shouldn't take bath. Eh? What I'm saying is this. It might not be a physical shower. They may be their character may be stinking. The way they talk, they may be stinking. And some of them were not like that before, but something just happened in their life. Like we said the other time, when life just happens, and life happened, and now they began stinking. They began stinking. But one thing that I don't want us to forget is the seed was elected. The seed was elected. Amen. It was elected. And now the seed comes, and the outer coat has been removed, and it goes down to the soil, and it dies. It dies. And for a while, the process of death, when the seed dies, before it germinates, there is silence. There is that process now of silence. And some of us, maybe probably that's where you are. You don't serve effectively. You don't, you're doubting even your prayer life. Like, God, I'm not praying enough. I'm not seeking God enough, and I'm trying. Have you ever been there? You're trying. It's not that you're not trying. It's not that you've given up. You're really trying to pray. You're trying to live holy. God, manze, nataka ni live holy. God, manze, I want to pray. I want to seek God. I want to read the word. But the time to give birth has come, but there's not that energy. You get? There's not that energy. You find yourself It's the process of death. There's that process. One thing I don't want you to forget is there is an election. I was elected. Amen. Doesn't matter what you see in your life, just remind yourself, I was elected. Amen. And then the seed dies, and in 2-3 days, this or 3 years, depending with the with the plant, the seed doesn't seem to thank you. And give it up for him. Today he prayed for the new converts. Yeah. This young man is so anointed. Amen. So the seed begins now. After a few days or a few years or a few months of death, the seed begins to produce something that goes downwards. It begins to produce something that goes downwards. And let me tell you, sometimes going down is not an easy thing. Going up is so easy because in terms of the plantation, because there is light, there is no obstacles. You keep going high. You keep going high. But going down, the seed has to dig the soil. For it to go down, it has to dig the soil. It has to fight with the soil to separate the soil so that it can go down. You get. Amen. It has to fight. It's a war fighting to go down. And when it has just died and it's coming up, it doesn't have enough strength. It doesn't have enough strength to go down. So it is something that is soft. A soft root, but still trying to push its way down, trying to push to get the new trains, to get the enough strength for it to go down, and it keeps going down, and some of us, that's where they are. They've just come to that process of using maybe vulgar language, coming from that process of becoming a lukewarm. And now you can pray for 2 minutes, trying to pray for 3 minutes, and some of us are like, manze, umse sim spiri, and I bring you 1 minute, umse mungine sim feel. We are there. You get? You're there, and you're trying. Inside you know, I have this potential. I have to go down. But there is no that. From the outside environment, there are no fruits. The soil upwards, it doesn't show any indication that there's hope. And then it keeps going down. And then when it has established, the root has established itself, it begins to produce something. And that's where, you remember the scripture, we say, there ariseth a cloud as small as man's hand. And that's where some of us are. Is that thing that is coming up. One thing I don't want you to forget still is I was elected. Amen. This seed was elected. This seed did not choose itself. This seed did not just come. It was elected. It was out of Jacob. He says that from Jacob have I chosen a seed to inherit my mountains. Amen. To inherit my mountains. And then it begins growing. It begins to come up. And when the plant is coming up, there is a certain worm that usually come. There's that worm that usually come, and most of the plants, they die at some point, because when you're shooting up, it is soft, it is yummy for the insects, because it has that juice. You get? It's shooting up. And one thing I want us as a family to take care of ourselves when it comes to that place. That is where love protects. That is where love comes in. You see, someone is trying to shoot up. Someone is trying to do things. They're trying to do what is right. They're trying to pray. They're trying to get that one chance. Can I share the word? That is now the time we need to take care of each other, because the worm, you know, that worm that usually comes and eats that plant, that's the time they come. And all we have to do is take everyone into remembrance that we all are elected. Amen. And because we are elected, we have to take care of this shoot so that it doesn't die. Amen. And then it keeps growing up. It keeps growing up. And there are also some challenges. Probably the weather, there is that sunlight that comes and it tries to make this thing die off, and it keeps going up. Why? The reason why it goes up is because of the grace of God. Amen. The reason we keep going up is because of the grace of God. The reason why we didn't die the time we were the seed is because God preserved us. The reason why we didn't die when we were going downwards and the soil was hard and the soil was rocky is because the grace of God sustained us. The reason why we didn't die when we were trying to shoot and we were soft and we couldn't pray, we couldn't even bind demons. When you get, you're new, you're trying to find your way into salvation, you're seeing people, they are rabashanda, they are binding, they are losing, they are throwing the legs, hitting the walls, and you're like, manzea sawana do. Yeah, have you ever been there? Have you ever been there? Have you ever gone to main church and they are praying and you're like, wah, Buddha, uko sirudi. Especially when it is spiritual warfare and they are binding. And we don't have that capacity. We cannot pray that way. And because we are still growing. Even that way, the reason why the worm didn't eat us is because the grace of God sustained us. Because some of us, even we didn't get the love from the church. We didn't get love from leaders. We didn't get love from the people we thought they could give us love. We didn't get it, but we still were sustained. We were sustained. Some of us, nobody taught us how to do things. Nobody taught you the way of life. No one taught you that doing this and this is wrong as you're growing up. But here you are because the grace of God sustained you. Amen. And we are still growing up. We are still growing up. Why? Because now the root is holy. Amen. The root is holy. And the Bible says if the root is holy, then so are the fruits. Can you imagine? We are still growing and we have not borne fruits. We have not borne fruits. But the Bible talks of the fruits because it knows the grace is sufficient to cause us to grow and bear fruits. God has already seen the fruits in you. God has already seen you in a place whereby we are bearing fruits. And God is specific. He says, the first fruits. The first fruits. There are other fruits that are coming. But the hardest fruits to bear, they are the first fruits. They're the first fruits. Right? The for the women who have I know it, here it doesn't apply much, but for them that have given birth, you will, when you do your research and read, they will say the first child is always the hardest to bear. Is always the hardest to bear, the first child, because it's, you don't have experience, and here comes and you have to give birth. And so that's why the Bible says the first fruits are holy. Praise God. And so we keep growing, we keep serving God. Now we at a place whereby we can pray, we can see God, our careers, they are beginning to blossom, things are working, we are bearing those branches, even before the fruits, tunaanza kubea ma branches, and things are coming up well. But now the Bible says the time for the fruits. There's the time for the fruits, because it doesn't matter how tall you grow. It doesn't matter how many branches you have. If you cannot produce the fruits, that tree is not worth to live. That tree must be cut and thrown into the fire. It doesn't matter how big it looks. Have you ever seen those big trees? They are big, but there's no fruit. There's no fruit. If you pray so much, we worship here so much, we preach, but if there's no fruits that can be found in us, still is a problem. Amen. Because it doesn't matter how much, it doesn't matter how much we do things, if we cannot bear fruits, if we cannot bear fruits and the fruits that remain, then God has not called us for that. He has not called us for that. If we cannot hold that one person that is going down, that one person that is going down, that's a fruit. If we cannot bear that one, then we are not there yet. Amen. We are not there yet. If I can't pray for that one person that is disturbing and you're praying over and over and they're not changing, if I can't keep praying for them, then I don't have the fruits. I may keep singing, I may keep prophesying, but if I cannot do something that is being seen, something that is tangible, something that people can see, the world can see and say, that lady, that young man has God in them. If there's nothing like that, then we are just growing but no fruits. Praise Jesus. And that's not our portion. That's not our portion. Because the Bible says, if the first fruit be holy, then the lamp is holy. If the first fruit be holy, then the lamp is holy. It means if the first fruit, if you bear that fruit, if you can be able to bear that fruit and that fruit is holy, it means that the rest of the fruits, they will be holy. If the first be holy, the rest, every other thing that follows, it becomes holy. And I want us to know that this year 2018, God has called us for holiness. Amen. He has called us for holiness, and this is the first fruit of holiness that we are going to give, because he say that if the first fruit be holy, then the lamp is holy. So what I want us, if you know you've not been living right in 2017, 2016, and you haven't been living right, this is the year you can't afford to live in holiness. You can't afford not to live in holiness. Praise God. This is the year you can't just take this year for granted. If you've not walked in love, this is that year you can't walk not with the love. Praise Jesus. This is the year where we shall love each other. Our soul shall be knitted together to the point of death, like David and Jonathan, because we care for each other, because we love each other, because we really are there for each other. Praise God. Praise God. That's what I'm calling us for, because the Bible says it began by saying, out of the seed of Jacob, he has called us. He has called us. We are those seeds, and he has called us. And personally, I believe everyone here, he has been called. Amen. We have been called. And because we have been called, we are going to inherit those mountains. And those mountains, we are going not to inherit alone, we're going to inherit them together. We're going to inherit them together. Amen. We're going to fight these battles together. Praise God. We're going to move together. You hurt, I hurt. Praise God. Praise Jesus. We're going to move. We're going to move with it. I pray for you, you pray for me. Praise Jesus. Praise Jesus. Yesterday I got something. I usually write some lyrics, and I got something that says, your heart, the heart of URT. Your heart is in my heart. Your heart is in my heart. Your heart is in my heart. Which means when you hurt, that heart affects my heart. Amen. And that's what I want us to have that. That when I hurt, my heart comes in your heart. Praise God. When we do that, it means we will care. It means we will move together. It means we will inherit whatsoever thing God wants us to inherit in 2018. Amen. And as a family, when it reaches in December, there's none of us that shall say that there's nothing God has done for me. There's nothing God has done for me. I don't want us to sing that song. I want us to proclaim and say, Ebenezer, the fire he has brought us. The mountains he has caused us to climb. The valleys he has taken us through. The desert he has taken us through. And we were together. We were together. We were together. Praise Jesus. I want to turn to your neighbor and hold their hands. Tell them this year, we are crying together. We are laughing together. We are moving forward together. We are moving forward together. Say it loud until they hear. And we are becoming one to the end. As a family. As a family. Amen. Amen. I don't want us to say that I don't know where Bom went. I don't know where Charlene went. But I want us in December, when we ask Major, where is Husna? You can say that we have walked this journey together. We have cried together. We have inherited the mountains together. Praise God. We have inherited together. We are not inheriting alone. We are inheriting together. We are not leaving anyone behind. We are going together. We are going as an army. Amen. And thank God to the gang that is coming up. Thank God for the gang that is coming up. Amen. We are that gang. Amen. We are the gang. We are ganging up together, and we are going to the Philistines. We are taking them and inheriting their possession. Praise God. In our careers, in our academics, in our callings, this year we are doing it. We are doing it together, and we are moving together. Amen. I want you again to hold your neighbor and tell them, I'm sorry where I walked alone. I'm sorry where I left you behind. I'm sorry where I hurt you. But this time round, no more hurtings. Amen. Put your hands together for Jesus and celebrate Jesus. Hallelujah. 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 Glory to God. It's okay. Amen. I want you to raise your hands in the air. I want you to make a simple prayer and tell God, God, this year I want to inherit your mountains. Let's make that prayer and tell God, I want to inherit your mountains. It doesn't matter what I see, but I want, because I am that seed that you've chosen. It doesn't matter the season of dying. I don't care the season of dying. But I want to take root, as we usually say, we take root downwards and bear fruit upward. I want to take that root this year. And I want to bear the first fruit. Because if the root is holy, then the lamp is holy. And I want to walk in holiness. Just tell God, I want to walk in holiness. This 2018, I want it to be the year that will be said, I walked in holiness. I walked in holiness. Make that prayer. Proclaim that prayer. There's power in the word. We've been told by the word of God that the word is in our mouth and it is in our heart. And so we are proclaiming it. We are saying it. We are believing in our mind, in our heart, until it becomes a reality. Until we walk in holiness. Until we bear fruits. Until we bear fruits that the world can eat, in the name of Jesus. And Father, we pray today that in the mighty name of Jesus, you are going to cause us this year to walk in oneness as you have chosen us as a seed. We pray that this seed shall take root downwards and bear fruit upwards. We shall live in holiness and walk in love. We shall love each other passionately, oh God. And Lord, we are not going to remain the same. This year you're going to cause us to inherit your mountains. I pray for everyone that they are going to school, that God, you shall cause them to become prosperous, to inherit in those schools, in the name of Jesus. In businesses, oh God, in families, oh God, may you cause us to become great. For this year, Lord, it's a year of greatness. It's a year of establishment. And we believe your word. We believe your word, God. We believe your word, oh God. We believe your word, oh God. In the name of Jesus Christ. In the name of Jesus. I want the ushers to help us to serve the communion.
Oh, holiness. Oh, oh.
Lift up that bread in the air. And Father, we partake of your body. Partake of the body of Jesus Christ. And we pray that as we partake, we remember you as our first fruit. The first fruit from the dead. And we ask of you that may you cause us to bear fruits, and fruits that remain. In Jesus' name we pray. You can eat your bread.
Lift up your cup. Father, in Jesus' name, we thank you for this cup. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, Lord, and as we partake it, Abba Father, Lord, I pray, Abba Father, that the life of Christ Jesus, Abba Father, will be made manifest in our bodies. in the mighty name of Jesus. Let the life of Christ Jesus be made manifest as we partake of it, Abba Father. Let it cleanse us. Let it wash us, Abba Father, in the mighty name of Jesus. We thank you, Lord, Abba Father. And if there be anyone, Abba Father, who is sick in our midst, Abba Father, Lord, as they partake of it, Abba Father, Lord, we send your word, Abba Father, in the name of Jesus. We thank you and we bless you in Jesus' name. You may take of your cup.
And Father, we thank you because of what you've given us. We thank you, God, because you've increased us. And 2018, increase our giving, increase our finances, increase us, God, as we go in, as we come out. May our financial level be increased, that, Lord, we shall increase from 50s to 100s, 100s to 1,000s, 1,000s to 10s of 1,000s, to 100s of 1,000s, God, even to millions, to 100s of millions, to billions, oh God, because we know that we shall walk in it. And those who believe, say amen. Amen, amen. You can give those baskets. If you're giving your tithe, you can come forward.
Nothing more for thee.